You have more power than you need.
Testing.
Hi. I'm Michelle Lalehzar. The first piece you are about to hear is Solomon Fugue, composed by Hovannis. When Bach North performed this piece at Carnegie Hall in 2004, Ms. Hovannis wrote the following. Dear Great Neck North High School musicians, it is the first day of March. I'm listening to my husband, Solomon Fugue. The work that you are about to hear. This year's spring has come early in Seattle. The first cherry blossom blossomed gloriously. I realize that Alan's music is living even though he has died. The Great Neck North musicians are like cherry blossom buds growing to reach the sky. Alan once said, the composer and the performer are united in beautiful cooperation for altruism of better civilization, and the world receives the benediction. All my best wishes from Alan and me, Hinako Fujinahara Hovannis, on the behalf of Alan Hovannis. Today, Mr. Rhapsodie called Mrs. Hovannis, and I got the opportunity to speak to her, and she's very delighted to know that high school students are playing her late husband's piece.
Of Great Neck for passing the budget and the bond. It is with your support that we need to bring artwork like what you see out in the lobby and in the gallery, drama what inspires you on the stage or in the commons like next Monday night, or the sounds that you're hearing tonight. Now I promised some people that I would not embarrass them tonight, like Bernie Kaplan, who made me promise not to mention that this was going to be his last Artfest, and Neil made me promise that I would not make a big deal about them, so I'm not going to do that. But I'm really going to miss them. I hope you know how much they mean to me and our students. But let me ask you something. In 1980, on this day, in 1980, does anybody remember what happened in Seattle? May 18, 1980. Mount St. Helens erupted, the volcano. Well, the following day, I decided to go to my high school dance, and I brought my gang, the Jets. Who at the dance but was Bernardo with his gang, the Sharks. Talk about stress. Forget about the AP exams. This was stressful. Then, right in the middle of us all dancing the mambo, my eyes met the eyes of a beautiful woman who happened to be Bernardo's sister, named
Maria,
but her name was Lisa. It was love at first sight. Ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow will be the 37th anniversary that I met Mrs. Rakowski, and I want to dedicate this performance of West Side Story to my wife, Lisa, who's up there in the fire escape, the balcony. You will recognize her because she's all red right now. She's got her fists clenched. Some people say that I'm a little nutty, but take my word for it. If it weren't for that woman, I would be a psychopath. And now, the love story of West Side Story.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
We're going to have a world premiere. This piece has not been heard in public, only in rehearsal. You will be the first audience to hear the first orchestral work by Zachary Lee.
Thank you.
interesting.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Rachel Berghauer. What's the most important thing?
Happy.
What's the next most important thing?
Oscar.
An empty chair makes no
sound.
Ladies and gentlemen, isn't that a fantastic art exhibit? Let's hear it for Mr. Jacqueline and for the art teachers, and especially for your children who created the art. Let's also hear it for Karen Lee and the music boosters. Without you boosters, we would have no concert. And let's hear it for Mr. Neil Sanderson, the busiest man on campus who never gets to take a bow for his own action. Grand Dyck actually has a professional publicist. That person is here tonight. Her name is Jessica Vega, and we owe her our excellent press coverage to Jessica. A round of applause for Ms. Vega, please. We have some special music teachers in our audience tonight. Please stand up when I say your name. Mr. Trinkwald. Thank you.
Thank you.